Good morning. I'm going to tell everybody, bear with me because I work on a turnpike and every day I drive for like 4 or 5 hours by myself, so I only have one person to talk to. So if I get carried away, just tell me to shut up. Okay? Today we gather together to remember a gentleman who dedicated many, many hours of his free time for the borough and the five-town area also that I found out when I was doing some research. Mr. John Gillen. Not only did he have a full-time job, raised a family, but he gave his free time for his community. Mr. Gillen served as mayor in the 70s. People were asking me about exact dates. One thing, if we have a problem with the way we moved our borough building around all over the town and everything else, a lot of these records are missing. But I did find it was in the 70s. And I found out too that through our centennial book is where I found a lot of this stuff out. He was instrumental in getting a lot of things between the communities started, like the Mid-Mont Valley Sewage Authority, which is still in effect. And I've learned too that it's very hard, even though we're a small area, to get our towns to work together on things. We're trying to break that, and we're trying to break that barrier. And also the five-town ambulance service. If you look on the building up there, there's a plaque and his name's on there. He was one of the original, he was mayor at that time when they started that, which was a great thing. And it's not that it's gone, it just got bigger. Now we're in with Brownsville and California and Ross Draver, and so we're one big ambulance service, so it's still alive. Also his work with Five Town Park. He's one of the founding members of Five Town Park. One thing that I still remember is he was involved with the bingo, and I just heard that a little bit ago. At St. Joe's Church, when I was 11 years old, he was my first boss. He hired me for bingo. I'm still working bingos now, 40 years later. So he has some, and I take care of the kids, so he, you know, influenced me on that. He had a real pride in his town. Today we take this opportunity, we want to name a street after him. It might not be a great big boulevard, but it's a nice street. A lot of memories on it and everything like that. It'll go with some of the other names, the Furlongs, Chester, Latta, Mankin, and last but not least, we just did one about a year ago, Adam, for Rich. And one thing about the street, I just thought about this when I was coming out of my house. Right by my corner is Mankin Street. And Wharton and I worked on the consoles and the fire hall and everything like that. And every time I come out, every once in a while, that'll catch my attention. It'll bring him back to my, you know, memory. And the same thing with this. Maybe kids in school will someday want to know why it's named Gillen. And they can research it back. And for the older people here, I guess I consider myself sort of older now, talk to the kids. Tell them about Roscoe. We get into it down at the fire hall all the time, showing them videos, the Danny Velocin's video, if anybody ever saw that on YouTube. It's great. You know, share it with the kids. They love it. That one night, I still think my wife thinks we were watching something bad on TV. But we had Danny's videos down there, and I was showing the kids, and we were pointing things out because we would say, where that empty lot was, there was a building there or something. And they loved it. And I still, like I said, I still think my wife thinks we were doing something else on TV, but we weren't. I'd like to turn it over to John's daughter and kids. They all want to say something, and then we'll finish up.
I have a story to share, but... Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll give you support.
Okay. My father met my mother up on the front street one rainy day about 70-some years ago under an umbrella, we always heard. And they moved, they got married after that and moved into the Roscoe Hotel. And then they moved to this little house right over here, that white one with the larger window. That's where Beck and I and
John
and Poke, yeah. Then we moved over here, and that's where my brother Nick was born. And I just realized that, you know, for my family, Roscoe was the heart and soul of everything, especially my dad. He just loved this here. And I keep imagining when he's going to look down and see this sign. I know he's going, you know, it was always easy with a smile anyways, but he'll probably giggle, I think so. He'll be very honored, I'm sure, as we are, that he has his name on the street, but it was special for him. And I could also imagine if he was here, he'd be saying something funny. There's no doubt. And
right.
I know he'd have some joke to tell. He always
He had the corny jokes.
Yeah, corny. And would probably hear it a couple times.
Yeah.
But he would feel really honored that his name was on this, and the family, as our family does also. Really sweet. And I want to thank the borough for getting this together. Thank you. And for, especially for Larry Papini, whose idea this was to come to go. I love that. And really, from our hearts, want to thank you for that. Thank you.
And I have a little story to tell, but I wanted to tell this because I think some of you might not know, and the ones that were back at the day in 1966 will remember it. But I want to say about my dad, he shared a joy with people that he worked with, his friends, that just was, you just had to be happy when you're around him. He had that just easygoing personality that just was, he just connected with everybody and made so many friends, and some of his good friends are still here today. And that I know when he worked at the bingo, he always kept things going. Making potato pancakes was his famous thing. But in 1966, I was just 16, and we were, gang of us with my dad, always took us swimming in the river. We were up at Elko at the local sandbar, having a fun day, everybody jumping in the water, and lots of families there. And all of a sudden, a mom started to scream that her son was missing. I can still hear those screams today. A six-year-old was under the water. My dad just took charge, and that changed my life forever. My dad, how he just took charge of everything and said, "Everybody, out of the water, clear the water." Everybody got out of the water. "Those of you that can swim, get back in and find him." And the ones of us, a little bit older ones, we start diving under the water. My cousin Gary Lewis, he's here today. He's still my hero. I can still see him. He pulled him out of the water and said, "I found him." He was not breathing, got him out of the water. My dad, in the meantime, sending my mom, there's no cell phones back then, sending my mom running to the closest local phone. I'm not sure where that was, but she took off and she called the ambulance, and by the time my dad got him on the ground, did CPR. Larry and I were talking the other day, who knew CPR back then, you know? But my dad, he did. He was trained somewhere along the line. He took charge, did CPR, and brought Jay Papini back to life that day. And by then, the ambulance came. Jay's not here today, but he's doing great. I just saw him the other day. He felt bad he couldn't make it. But Larry and the Papini family are here. They've been forever grateful. And that they're the ones. A couple months ago, they said, "Hey, wouldn't it be nice to have a sign named for your dad that was in the Roscoe?" And I thought, yeah, that'd be great. So they sort of initiated it and got the borough. So thank you, everyone involved. And keep my dad's spirit going. So, all right.
I guess it's a learning experience for all of us, even though we knew all this, but we're learning so much more. Like they said, Mr. Papini has actually brought it to our attention at the council. With everything going on, it doesn't always come to light to do these kind of things. And these people step up and say, "Hey, we need to do this." Right. And the council had no problem. Dorothy Hartman here with us, Dawn Papellis, council members. There was no question, no debate or anything else. They said, "Do it, go get the signs." We probably would have did this 3 months ago, but it takes so long to get them made up, but it did. We ordered them right away, but it took a long time for them to come in, so they're finally here. Mr. Papini, would you like to say anything?
My dad's for years.
It always amazed me how families get tied together. You never know why. And something happens in a lifetime that brings those families together. Johnny Gillen and I were on council together. I'd come to his house sometimes after council meeting and play. They used to have a pool table down there. I don't know whether they still have it or not. Where we'd go to the Slovak Club and have a beer and just BS. One night I went down there and I hit the book. I mean, hello. Why would I hit the book?
Well, anyway, excuse me.
Johnny Gillen and Gary Lewis did something in my lifetime that people will never understand. No, they'll understand, but hopefully it never happens to them. And they just told me a story about my wife taking the kids up in Elko to swim and basically saved our son's life because they knew what to do. And in turn, it's hard to give back to somebody that's done an honor for you like that. So the best my wife and I could do every Christmas was send flyers to Gary Lewis and Johnny Gillen, just as a remembrance and a thank you. I mean, you can't pay your way for that kind of thing. You can only show the appreciation that exists when families come together. In fact, I have a picture up at our house with Johnny Gillen and my son Jay making his first communion. It's a cherished picture, and it really means for my wife and I and our family, how people in small towns, not that it doesn't happen in big towns, but in small towns, they come together and they don't even ask, what should I do? They just do it. So it's nice that this sign will let his name live forever and his offspring always remember what a good man he was. So, to Johnny Gillen and Gary Lewis, our family thanks you.
Let me just say a couple words, then we'll pull it off and we'll bless it, okay? Because anything we do for Johnny and Dee definitely needs to be blessed. I'm listening to Tom and Larry, and there's a couple things that come to my mind. First of all, that a community isn't a community unless people are rooted in it, okay? Unless they've got some skin in the game. And that's what makes Roscoe so special, so unique. People are rooted here. And especially people like Iggy and Johnny and Joe and Tom and Larry, everybody. Well, I can't get all the names in. But honestly, I mean, that's what makes it a special community. And I was thinking when Becky was talking about the swimming day. I remember Iggy and Johnny talking about when they used to swim in that river and things were floating by, and it just oh. I didn't want to hear about it, but it goes back that far, okay? And what a beautiful story about meeting your wife right up here. And living like that doesn't happen. This is such a treasure. It really is. The other thing that I thought of, especially when Tom was talking about the number of streets named after people, is the scriptures. And the scriptures saying that that the church, for instance, are living stones. The church isn't buildings. Roscoe aren't just buildings. It's the living stones. It's the people that live here. And that that so many times even the street names remind us of the living stones that create this community, and that there are certain foundation stones. And John and Dee, who was always there right by his side, is certainly one of those foundation stones in this community. And so it's such a pleasure to be back with all of you. It's such a pleasure to remember John. I think all of us think of John the same way, and that is that whenever we needed him, he was there. whenever we needed him, like Larry said, people don't ask, well, can I help you? He just showed up. He did it. Whether it was at St. Joe's or up at the cemetery, or he was just there. And I'll never ever forget him for that. Okay, let's go. Lord Jesus, you said you are the way, the truth, and the life. We honor this disciple of yours. We honor this Christian who followed you and whom you have led into eternity. We pray that John and Dee may smile on us today. We pray that they may feel our love as we honor them with this street sign and as we pray in their memory. Bless this sign. Bless all who walk it on this street. Bless all the people of this borough. Amen.
Amen.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit.